beat you, they tried to counterfeit you.
Yeah, and they certainly wouldn't say, well, you know, he has a good point there or there, but the rude laughing and the ridicule, I think that's going to go away. So far, it's gone away, and I don't know whether they'll go back to that or not. So there's reason for us to say there's a good reason to keep doing exactly what we're doing and using what is available to us, you know, which radio shows and which internet programs, and there's just a lot available to us. It's not like when there were just three major networks and hardly anybody on talk radio that would, you know, defend our position. So that's where, you know, I'm optimistic. But on the short run, there are days when I think about the overwhelming problems we face. And, you know, we're just starting to see what happens when the government can't come through, you know, like in places like Greece where the promises can't be fulfilled. People get angry. That's going to be happening here, too.
Well, there's a good chance you're going to become president, but regardless, we've got to supercharge your campaign so you can be at the very forefront the entire time, injecting real issues so that as the implosion comes in the future, people will know what you said and our movement for liberty with you as a focal point will be that much bigger and stronger to offer real solutions, and we'll end up having a president poll one way or the other. So folks need to have a long-term vision. Do you agree with that?
Absolutely. We have to have a long-term plan because nothing happens overnight. And if you had asked me 5 years ago how far along we would be in this effort, I would have not been very optimistic that we could have achieved what we have so far. So things are moving, but it means that we still have a long way to go, too, and there's lots up for grabs. And when people lose power, they can get pretty nasty because they do not want to give up that power. And the people who control the money and the system and the appropriations process and the international affairs and all these things, they will not go away quietly. They will be, pretty determined to cling to their power.
Kicking and screaming. All right, we've only got 4 or 5 minutes left running through these quick questions. I was surprised to see Congressman Nadler, big Democrat, come out and say Obama is becoming an emperor. Just as you said weeks ago, the last nail in the Republic's coffin, if Congress lets the president not even consult Congress and say, my authority comes from the UN, quote, I've done this for the legitimacy of the UN. I mean, sir, is that not seditious? Is that not treason? Is it not impeachable what President Obama has done with this whole Libya thing, and now they're getting the ground invasion ready?
Oh, sure. And in a different age, it would have been impeachable, and it would have probably followed through. But up until recent years, they've either gotten permission or token permission. But it's been bad for a while. Truman certainly did not do anything to notify Congress. He just marched in under UN, into Korea. And they got token permission, you know, for Vietnam and these other events. But once again, Bosnia was no permission, no consultation, and this is the same way in Libya. But there, you know, although the Congress is waking up and there's a pretty good coalition of liberals and conservatives, Republicans and Democrats coming together and trying to slow this thing up and say the president has no right to do this. At the same time, on this DOD budget authorization, you know, they inserted in there an expansion of the power. Actually, if it's passed by the Senate and put in the law, we've literally legalized, we put into the code, even though not at the Constitution, put into the code that the president doesn't have to come to us. They've expanded the definition of our enemy. Today it's Al-Qaeda, and they're allowed to do almost anything there. But they've expanded it to include the Taliban and anything which is considered an associated force. The associated forces, the president has the right to go after, no matter what country, or including our own. So this, to me, was one of the most dangerous changes in our law. Was giving legitimacy to our president on what he's been doing. And of course, there's not much resistance either from the Republicans or the Democrats on this. But hopefully we can wake the American people up to that change.
What about Obama, admittedly, going to have feds pose as people calling doctors to see if they're taking Medicare, Medicaid patients, which is their right to not do, as you know. This is really freaking doctors out that now the feds are going to be spying on them.
Yes, and I would assume that most of people don't realize that's against the law to do those kind of things. I mean, why should they violate the privacy, you know, of a doctor-patient relationship and come in and fake? It's fraud. It's deceitful. And what kind of punishment might these doctors? What if the doctor say, I don't take medical care patients? You know, who knows what kind of a list you get put on there? But no, that's just one thing leads to the next. Always an unintended consequence. Every time the government does one thing, they create two or three new problems.
Congressman, just a couple questions left here, and then we're going to ask you how we support the campaign again. Operation Fast and Furious, just to remind listeners, the head of the ATF caught lying to Congress saying he didn't know. Now we have the emails and memorandum. They were running the operation to ship guns into Mexico to then claim that we're causing the violence down there, a form of false flag, a staged event to frame the Second Amendment. He's caught lying. Can you or others call for congressional hearings and haul these people up and expose what the dreaded ATF has done?
Oh, I'm sure that would be legitimate if somebody's so motivated. I don't happen to be on that particular committee. But, yes, government oversight could do that. They could call up and get to the bottom of it. But I haven't heard a whole lot of talk. I don't have any special information on that. But they certainly can, and they certainly should.
Yeah. In closing on the political issues, there's new reports out in mainstream television and newspapers that cancer is surging in body scan operators, the TSA at the Boston airport, where it's been for 7 years, and they've had an internal cover-up of the fact that they know that radiation is leaking out of these. Could this be the nail in the coffin of this federal TSA, that they knowingly are not following radiation rules or radiology rules that you'd follow in your practice? And that,
let's hope so, but isn't it sad that they have to come to that conclusion after somebody's made sick or get cancer? But the big thing is we got to get the government out of that business. So if they get rid of the machines, then they're going to do a lot more probing and prodding and poking everybody. So it's really tragic. I think what's happening at airports is the litmus test. If the American people can sit back and look at some of those pictures and not be outraged and not demanding changes, when I see that, that's when I have some pessimistic thoughts about what's going to happen in this country. So this hope that those pictures will so outrage the people that we'll end up doing something about it.
Speaking of the TSA, I've got sources inside the Perry campaign and at Fox News. As you know, Rick Perry, the governor, is planning to run. I would imagine you've got the same intel. And he's going to run on a Ron Paul platform. So he's really going to be the guy you face from our analysis. And Rick Perry quietly tried to kill the good bill. They've rewritten it. Where it actually puts in the code that the TSA can do this now in Texas, and they're calling it an anti-TSA bill, kind of like what we saw with the War Powers doublespeak of saying they're against what Obama's doing but trying to give him the power.
All right. That's typical. That's why you can never look what they do on the surface. When people want something done, they'll pass a bill and it'll do the opposite, whether it was the War Powers Resolution or this recent episode of that bill they tried to pass, which literally legalized the war. So, yes, that's what they do, and then they claim victory.
What's your view of Perry? What's your view of Perry?
Well, I might have shaken hands with him, but I don't even remember that. So I don't know him well personally, but I would think that he and I wouldn't have much in agreement on policies.
Well, he was Al Gore's former campaign manager in Texas. I don't think that's a very good...
that ought to tell a few people something.
Well, Congressman, you seemed really happy because you're always so focused, because I know you're a very disciplined man. But when I talked to you in the break before you came live, I don't think I've ever heard you so happy. Am I right in that? I mean, you said, well, I'm sad for the country, but overall I'm happy that folks are starting to wake up. I mean, you are happy.
Yeah, I am. And things have personally with family and everything has been going pretty well. And that's what I guess cheers me up.
Well, thank you, sir. In closing, because I've got millions of listeners, a lot of new big stations across the country. We're not talking to just a million every day. We're talking to 3 million every day on the radio alone, not just internet later. We're reaching about 10 million a week. Talking to the millions of new listeners who've never heard you in a long form. They've heard you on TV being interrupted constantly. What can they do to be part of this second American revolution or the restoration of the republic? Give us the orders from headquarters. What do we do to supercharge a campaign that's already on fire?
In very general terms, slightly separate from the campaign, what everybody has to do is be informed, get the information and find out where the problem is and what the answers are and why philosophy is important. When they're informed, then they have to do something, and they can make choices. They can get involved directly. They can become candidates or support candidates. They can get into education. They can get radio talk shows. They can get on the internet to promote this message. But then when it comes more specific for what I've been doing, you know, we had the educational opportunities through my foundation as well as Campaign for Liberty, but right now we are very much engaged in the presidential campaign. People who are interested in that can go to ronpaul2012.com and find out what they can do, because that's where we need the help. We need people to volunteer. We need to raise money, and right now the next big event for us is to try to find people in Iowa. If anybody knows anybody in Iowa that would be willing to support us and make an effort and come out on August 13th, that would be very helpful to us.
And when's the next money bomb? And folks can give right now at ronpaul2012.com.
Well, there is an effort right now, because on the 30th of this month, the books close, and you know there's a big, that report is significant because it will be blasted all over the country on who raised what. And we won't be the biggest fundraiser, but we're going to have raised a lot. But they were trying to push for, first for three, then somebody said, maybe we can raise five. And I think it's not quite at $4 million right now. So the next couple of days, we're hoping to boost that up and have a good showing for the financial reports of this quarter.
All right, Congressman. Well, thank you so much. Okay. We'll talk to you again soon. Thank you
so much. Thank you.
All right, there goes, thank you. There goes Congressman Ron Paul, ladies and gentlemen. Very, very exciting information, and great to have him on the broadcast with us today. Now, continuing here, we're at the end of the official broadcast. We're going to do internet only, prisonplanet.tv, and infowars.com. Webster Tarpley from Tripoli coming up. I want to just plug that we have the new free newsletter. If you go to the top of Infowars.com, it says Infowars Insider, exclusive videos, articles, photos, going out every Tuesday, right after the show ends. It starts blasting out after 2. So if you want to go sign up right now, just put your email in, hit sign up now, and we will send you that. And we're going to start sending out daily email blasts with key intel, photos, exclusive videos that are only available through that newsletter. It's another system that goes directly to you, not through Twitter that could shut us down, not through YouTube that could shut us down, not through Google. They could shut down our web servers for our websites, but we'd still have this other platform on separate servers to send you emails. That's why we're developing and building up the InfoWars Insider. Then you can take newsletter and forward it to your friends and family, and folks can sign up right there in the newsletter that they get for that. So a special report on how resistance is victory. That's this week's main article. Is going to be going out in the next 15 minutes or so. So go to Infowars.com, top right-hand corner. It says the Infowars Insider. Also, to financially support this radio broadcast and help get the word out, you can get my 5 best-selling films, Police State 4, Fall of the Republic, Endgame, Terror Storm, and Obama Deception for $29.95. The special ends Friday. And get a free Mark Dice Big Brother, the Orwellian Nightmare Come True on top of that. That is an incredible deal. Infowars.com. Or you can also call toll-free 888-253-3139. 888-253-3139. And, of course, you can also sign up at prisonplanet.tv. All right. God bless you all. See you back tomorrow, 11 a.m. Central. We're going to do an hour on the internet only at Infowars.com.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Cowbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps. that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog.